Mensuration. Mensuration involves in finding the area and perimeter of plane figures and surface areas and volumes of solids. We will see a few examples using this idea. If we take in this question, we have a pencil. A pencil is made up of a cylinder and a cone. So, in order to find the volume of pencil, that will be equal to volume of cylinder plus volume of cone. Volume of the cylinder is pi r square h and the volume of a cone is 1 over 3 pi r square h. Now, we'll substitute all our values over here. So, 3.142 into the radius, the diameter is given to us. Diameter is given as 0.7 in the figure. So, our radius will be equal to 0.7 divided by 2. So, it is 0.35. So, our radius is 0.35 squared into the cylinder's height is 16.5 plus 1 by 3 into 3.142 and then the radius remains the same, that is 0.35 square and the height of the cone is 1.5. So, all these we have to find the volume. When we use our calculator, we will get our answer as 6.54 centimeter cube. This is the A part of the question. Now, our B1. Now, to find the width of the pencil, that is W, we need to find. In order to find, we know the diameter for one pencil is 0.7 centimeter. So, number of pencils. Pencils in a row. Is 6 pencils are there in a row. So, therefore, our width will be equal to 0.7 multiplied by 6. That is 4.2 centimeters. In the same way, for the value for x, it will be 0.7 into 2. So, that will be equal to 1.4 centimeters. Now, our B2, volume of box will be equal to, it is the volume of cuboid. Volume of cuboid is LBH. Now, our length will be equal to 13 into, it is given in our question, it is 13. Then 4.2 into 1.4. Everything when you multiply, you get your answer as 105.84. So, when we write it to three significant figures, 106 centimeter cube. The third part is percentage of space occupied by the pencils. For this, we have to write our answer as 12 into volume of one pencil. This is our required volume. Divided by volume of the box into 100. So, this 12 into volume of a pencil we have found out in our part A, which is 6.54, volume of one pencil. Then we have also found the volume of the box, which is 105.84 into 100. See, when we write here 105.84, we have to write the entire value. We will not write a simplified value which we have written to three significant figures as 106. So, when we simplify this, we get our answer as 74.2 percentage. So, this much percentage the pencil has occupied in the box. Now, in C1, they are asking us to find the slant height. That is, the height of the cylinder is given as 1.5. And the radius is 0.7. Our slant height L equal to square root of R square plus H square. This we get by using our Pythagoras theorem. So, this will be equal to R is 0.7 square plus 1.5 square. So, it will be equal to 1.54 centimeter. This is our slant height. Now, in the second part, we need to find the total surface area of the pencil. So, whichever face is there in the figure, we have to find out. So, the base is a circle. So, that is the area of the base, which is a circle, area of the circle plus then the curved part of the cylinder. curved part of the cylinder, that is curved surface area of cylinder. Then the top is a cone, that is also only a curved part is visible to us, curved surface area of cone. All these formulas, when we substitute, the answer we get will be the total surface area of the pencil. So it will be, if we write out our formulas, for a circle it is pi r squared, then the curved surface area of the cylinder is 2 pi r h, then for a cone it is pi r l. We'll just substitute all the values and use your calculator, and then we'll find out the answer. So it will be pi into 0.35 square, pi r square, plus 2 into 0.35 into 16.5 plus pi into 0.35 into 1.54. So when we use the calculator, if we simplify, we get our answer as 38.4 centimeters square. And since they have mentioned that you have to write your answer to three significant figure, you have to write only to three significant figure. When you write more numbers in this, and if you are not writing your answers to three significant figures, your marks will get deducted. This figure has got two hexagons and six rectangles. In order to find the total surface area, we can find the area of the hexagon and multiply by 2. Then plus area of a rectangle multiplied by 6. This gives us a total surface area of a given figure. In order to find the area of the hexagon, we have divided this hexagon into 6 triangles. And these triangles are all equilateral triangles. Area of an equilateral triangle, it is root 3 over 4 a squared, where a is the side. So we'll be using that over here. 2 into root 3 over 4, and here the hexagon side is of 4 centimeters. So it will be into 4 square plus 6 into area of the rectangle. That is one rectangle, the width is 4 and the length of this rectangle is 12. So when we simplify this, we get our answer as 371 centimeter square. The next question is based on the flowing of the water. When the water flows, we can calculate it as a volume. So volume will be equal to the flow of water, or the water flow will be equal to speed into cross-sectional area into time. If the water is flowing through a cylindrical pipe, then the cross-section is a circle. If the water is flowing through a hexagonal pipe, then the cross-sectional will be a hexagon. Like that, it depends on the figure whichever the water is flowing through. Now, the water flow is given as 12 liters. So, volume over here is 12 liters. 1 liter will be equal to 1000 centimeter cube. So, 12 liters will be equal to 12 multiplied by 1000. So, it will be equal to 12,000 centimeter cube. Now, we'll substitute all the values which are given in the question. So, volume is calculated, that is 12,000 will be equal to, we need to find the speed, into here the cross section is a circle because it is given that it is flowing through a cylindrical pipe. So, pi into 0.74 square, and then the time is given as 4 minutes. So now, when we calculate our speed, will be equal to 12,000 divided by pi into 0.74 square. This will be equal to 1743.6 centimeter per minute, because the time is given as 4 minutes. So when we write our answers to three significant figures, it is 1740 centimeters per minute. In the second part, it is given the water is flowing into a circular pond. And when the water flows, there is an increase in the height of 5 millimeter. That will be equal to 5 over 10 centimeter. That is 0.5 centimeter. So there is an increase of 0.5 centimeter. So, which is a very small difference in the height. So, if we take this part of it, though I have marked it as a slant, but this one only will form like a cylinder only for us over here. So in this, we have to calculate the radius of the cylinder. 12 liters of water is flowing into it. So 12 liters will be equal to 12,000 centimeter cube. This volume will be equal to the volume of the cylinder. So it will be pi r square h will be equal to 12,000. So r square will be equal to 12,000 divided by pi. And the how much is the height? The height has increased. So this height is 5 millimeter. So 5 millimeter, that will be equal to 0.5 centimeter. So when we simplify this, we get our value for r. Simplify this, taking the square root of it, we'll get our value for r as 87.398. That will be equal to 87.4 millimeters. Then the next question, the solid is made up of a cone and a hemisphere. So in order to find the volume of solid will be equal to volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere. So volume of a cone formula is 1 by 3 pi r square h and the volume of a hemisphere is 2 by 3 pi r cube. We'll just substitute all the values. So 1 over 3 into pi into 7 squared into 13 plus 2 over 3 into pi into 7 cubed. So this will give us an answer of 1384.7 centimeter cubed. If you are writing it to three significant figures, 1380 centimeter cubed. We have to find the mass of the solid. In order to find the mass, it is given in the question that 1 centimeter cube equal to 0.94 grams. So mass of the solid 1384.7 multiplied by 0.94. So it will be equal to 1300 grams. So 1.3 kg, we have written it to one decimal place. See, so here too, I am not taking this three significant figure value. I am taking the entire value over here to find the answer. And here they are asking us to give our answer to one decimal place. So I have given the answer over here to one decimal place. Curved surface area of cone will be equal to pi r width. Now when it is an L over here, let us first calculate L. L will be equal to square root of 3 square plus 7 square. Instead of getting this answer, we'll just write, instead of L, we'll write this itself directly over there. So it will be pi into r7 and L is square root of 3 square plus 7 square. When we simplify this, we get our answer as 324 centimeter square. In the C part, the cost of the gold for covering the entire solid is given as 411.58. We have to find the cost for 1 square centimeter. In order to find, we'll just find first the surface area of the solid. Surface area of solid will give us surface area of cone plus surface area of hemisphere. Here we are calculating the surface area because they have covered the solid only on the outer faces, not anywhere inside. So that is why curved surface area of the cone and curved surface area of the cylinder. Curved surface area of the cone we have already calculated. That is 324 plus curved surface area of the hemisphere is 2 pi r squared. So it will be equal to 324 plus 2 into pi into 7 squared. This will give us an answer of 631.7 centimeters squared. Now, for 631.7 centimeters square, the cost is $411.58. Now, for 1 centimeter squared, we need to find our cost, which is our x, or we can take it as a cost. Our cost will be equal to 411. 0.58 divided by 631.7, which will give us an answer of 0.6515. This will be equal to 65.1 cents. Using the formula for area, curved surface area and volume, we can find the required answers. Thank you.